Just 5 minutes, I wanted you to do an exercise. Whatever you think, go on pinning down, write down. Because in that, you see, don't edit now. Write down. After that, if you read, you will understand how many negative fulfilling commitments you are giving to you. How many negative commitments you are giving it to you, you can find out. In 5 minutes, 25 negative commitments. Then why your life will be positive? Please start. Please take this worksheet also. Make a list of commitments you gave to yourself and to others in your life. Working, tireless working, no break and no rest. How many of you observe? How many of you think, will Swamiji not have any vacation? I tell you, what is your fantasy about vacation? Maybe a beach and your spouse or a girlfriend or boyfriend and rest, food, maybe a spa, all that. Even the vacation, how I imagine, you know, I'll be sitting in the chair when I turn east conducting inner awakening. When you guys are doing your homework, when I turn towards the west, the organizers meet. Turn towards the north, the ashramites approval. Turn towards the south, the other vision department, many other departments approval. This is what my vacation. Usually when you write first time, you only learn to write. You don't learn to internalize. Now when you internalize and write, you will understand how many things you missed yesterday. Listen. Look into the relationship you share with yourself. Identify and write down the thoughts and words you use internally to describe yourself. Identify and write down the thoughts and words you use externally to share with others about yourself. Identify if there is any mismatch between these two and write that down in your notebook. Look into the relationship you share with your mother. Identify and write down the thoughts and words you use inside you to describe your mother. Identify and write down the thoughts and words you use externally to share with others. This includes even your mother, about your mother. Identify if there is any mismatch between these two and write that down in your notebook. Listen. It is to teach you, make you internalize how the fantasy is built on negativity, reality is built on integrity. Fantasies are built on negativity, reality is built on integrity. If you are a child, you may need fantasies, fairy tales, to cope up with the reality. Even after becoming adult, if you need fairy tales to cope up with reality, you are mentally retarded. Okay? And third, look into the relationship you share with your father. Identify and write down the thoughts and words you use internally to describe your father. How many of you in your young age believed your father can do everything? I believed. Anything and everything on the planet Earth. I believed. So, identify and write down the thoughts and words you use externally to share with others. This includes even your father, about your father. Identify if there is any mismatch between these two and write down in your notebook. Answer all these three questions along with the first question I gave you. Means just for 5 minutes, whatever comes out, pen down to find out how constantly you are thinking negatively. Please start. How many of you found very clearly you are thinking as so much of negativity? Raise your hand. And Your fantasy is built on negativity. Reality is built on integrity. Raise your hand. Come on, let me listen to some of the stories. Come out. Let me listen to some of your sharings, your discoveries. Please come. If you have not discovered, I will help you to discover. Please come.
Swami, this is to do with the thoughts that went through the mind.
Yes.
That's the list. The thoughts that were going through without any sequence was, will my tax problem be resolved? Will I be able to handle it from here without my presence because I will not be home before the 31st of March? My son is taking a loan. I hope that assessee assesses the flat properly so that he gets the amount of money that he needs. Will the amount of money that he has be sufficient to be able to go through with this purchase of the flat? Then suddenly my father's inauthenticity at times came to mind, who's long gone. Then my mother's love for me suddenly came in, maybe because I was reading about her. And the water pipeline near the house is supposed to have broken because the maid called in the morning, they're building the road. So I hope someone will get the pipe to repair that. Things like this from
you. That's all. No, this is enough. This is enough. No. I just wanted to verify. See, now, please listen. Non-integrity in thinking, thinking in fantasy is because some parts of your brain is not fully alive. Please listen. I am making a very important statement. Your thinking is based on fantasy, not based on reality, because your awareness is very low and some parts of your brain does not function when your awareness is low. If your awareness is raised, that part of the brain starts functioning, which we call non-mechanical parts. And that directly leads you to think in integrity without fantasy. Thinking in integrity. I tell you, all training in the world is nothing but thinking with integrity. If you have this one training, thinking with integrity, anything, any training for you is easy. How many of you cognize this thinking with integrity will make me successful in anything I touch? How many of you are able to cognize that? This kriya we are going to do, I'm going to awaken some non-mechanical parts of your brain. Exactly this part, this line. Here there is a line. Inside that part only, when it is awakened, it gives you the awareness. Even while you are thinking, you will even listen your own talking to yourself. Through this kriya, which we are going to do now, through this process, I am working on awakening that part so that your thinking can be with awareness. It doesn't have to be fantasy based. It can be aligned with integrity, aligned to integrity. Clear? Are we ready? Please use the mic.
Swamiji, have you got an example of thinking with fantasy? I'll tell you why I'm asking. Because I learned a lot about positive.
For example, I'll give you some. Who is the person with whom you have conflicts in your life?
My boss.
boss. Many time, the moment you remember your boss, the some work which you need to do with your boss, the moment you remember him, because of your fantasy about him, you will not further think about that work and drop it. You cognize what I am saying? Fantasy is not always meaning good. Which is not there, which you visualize, is fantasy. Clear? You are able to cognize what I am saying? But with integrity, if you think, there may be something, you have a conflict, but there may be something which you will never expect, he will support you. Because of your fantasy, you will never catch that space. That's where the problem is. Yes, come on.
Swamiji, is there anything, a good fantasy?
Nothing, no. Nothing? Good reality only. Reality is always good. Yes, please go ahead.
Swamiji, a small doubt. Regarding the mismatch between our, what we think about our mother and how do we pose her to the external world. If there is mismatch, is that is wrong or?
No, I am not saying right or wrong. There will be mismatch, that's all. You need to know. Whether it is right or wrong, we will see in the next sessions. Yes. Please go ahead.
Swamiji, then why are we always attracted to fantasies rather than...
No, we are not attracted to it. We are attracting it. I'll just say the why I'll answer later on, and why, how, all that we will address later on. Now I am only making you aware of few basic thoughts, knots. How we are going to go beyond it, we will do it further. I am only just making you aware. And now please listen. This kriya all of you can do, but the special attention needed group, do it as little less. Don't strain yourself. You understand? Special attention needed group. Ma, you only, ma. You are able to catch what I am saying? Okay, great. All special attention needed persons, please raise your hand. Please don't strain yourself too much. But you can do this kriya. We'll start. You can sit on your knees, Vajrasana. Vajrasana. Listen. Please listen. From the bottom of your belly, you will be chanting loudly H-O-O. The sound of who you will exhale through mouth and loudly chant this mantra, because I chanted it, started chanting. Ready? Okay, please tie the ribbon. Start as intensely as possible and as loudly as possible chanting the Omkara mantra. Intensely exhale. Along with chanting, exhale. We'll gather again for the next session. Let's gather for next session. Thank you.